Take a good look around. I'm sure you'll find what you're looking for. Everything. Some may call this junk. Me, I call them treasures.
Okay, I will buy all of the healing potions you have. And sell you all this junk. I don't remember reading that. Circle it in Minor Magicka. Oh, I don't have, or he doesn't have that much money. Okay, I'll sell that. Okay.
Do come back.
So now I'm gonna travel probably to Solitude if I've discovered it. Yeah. Sorry, it's been, as usual, a week since I last played, so I can't remember very well where I have and haven't been.
What could it mean? The return of the Dragonborn? And who among us could possibly hold that honor and such power?
Me. I could. Okay, it's practically 9 anyways. If I just wait 12 hours, then I should be good.
Take a good look around. I'm sure you'll find what you're looking for.
Are you?
If not,
oh, hi.
Let me know. You're a traveler, correct? Have you been to Whiterun? Wonderful. I hadn't really hoped to run into someone who'd
okay.
been there. My daughter Fura was assigned to
I remember this quest.
To join the Imperial Army. I was hoping you might have met her.
I haven't heard
from her lately. I've tried talking to Captain Aldous, but he hasn't been any help. Oh, that's very sweet of you. Anything you can find out from Captain Aldous would be welcome news.
All right.
So you're interested in my potions and ingredients?
Do you have any healing potions? Ah, you got a load of healing potions. The little loading screens say that Whiterun is the center of trade in Skyrim because it's got a very large central position, but usually I find the best stuff you can buy from Solitude. Probably something to do with the fact that it's most directly connected to the Empire. Okay, and I don't have anything else to sell.
Me next time you need herbs and potions.
Okay, bits and pieces. It's Solitude's general store.
Got something for just about everybody in here. Give a holler if you have any questions. How do you feel? Some might call this junk.
She said that to me too.
Treasures.
I might actually be sick then. I should check my active effects to see if I'm sick. It's interesting that you're actually selling ingredients. Oh.
Take a look.
Okay, yeah, this shopping trip's been long overdue. I'm not sure how much of this episode is gonna be shopping trip. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Oh well, it's just 1 grand, so. Not like it's the most expensive thing in the game. You know what, I'm actually gonna buy that back. You know, I'm gonna buy only one of them back because I don't have that much money. I could reload, but I don't think I'm going to. I think that might kind of go against the whole easy core thing, because this idea of easy core is like, I don't get reloads. I can't just go back. I can't. It's like I'm supposed to be doing this in one shot. I don't have a go back. I don't have a contingency plan in case I accidentally do something wrong. It's like if I get something wrong, I get something wrong. And it's stuck like that. Unless something happens, like I get stuck in an area that can't be moved from, but most of the time I can just fast travel out of those.
Come back to bits and pieces anytime.
You have an alchemy table in here? You don't.
That was just sitting there? I wish I found it first.
What was just sitting there? What are you talking about? I didn't pick anything up. Okay. I've never heard that line before, actually. The wow, that was just sitting there. I wish I had found it first.
Got something for just about everybody in here. Give a holler if you have any questions.
All right. Alright. Actually, I think I might have to head back in here in half a second again, because I'm gonna come over here, and never mind. Okay. I think that's good enough for the shopping for now. How long have I been recording? Probably not very long. Yeah, 40 minutes, so second episode, probably around a third of the way through. Hi. And I, Hrothgar, to talk to the Greybeards. I don't think I've ever seen a dragon with that style before. It's interesting. But all kinds of dragon. Blood dragon, ancient dragon, legendary dragon, normal dragon, all kind of named dragons. I don't think I've ever seen a dragon look like that before, though. Arngir, you are marked on my map. Or my quest thing, your Wolfgar. This is very odd music for this situation. Oh, well, that's annoying. Ha! Oh, you're sleeping. You guys sleep?
Alduin? We heard the Dragonwind shout from here. You defeated him? I feared as much. I thought it was him we saw flying east after your battle. We are not warriors. What is overlooked in the Dragonborn is not permitted to any other followers of the way of voice.
You misunderstand our authority. The Greybeards have never involved themselves in political affairs.
I see. The dragon will lead you to Alduin, but without the Jarl's help.
Yes.
Parthenax has made the decision to help you. This is the road we have to walk. Even the Greybeards must bend to the winds of change, it seems. So be it. Tell Ulfric and General Tullius that the Greybeards wish to speak to them. We will see if they still remember us.
All right, I can do that.
Win. Guide.
So after I complete the main quest, what quest line do you want me to do? Like, there's quite a few options. There's the Dawnguard quest line on either the Vampire or the Dawnguard side. There's the Thieves Guild quest line, Dark Brotherhood, College of Winterhold. I said Thieves Guild, I think. There's a Companions. The Ethereum quest is quite nice. And cold
meat. Are my men now giving free rein to anyone who wanders into the castle?
Apparently.
Do you have some reason to be here, citizen?
Yes, I do, actually.
Have one. Oh, you were at Helgen. One of the prisoners, if I recall correctly.
No, I did not come here to fight for the Empire. Goodbye.
Ulfric's planning an attack on Whiterun.
Okay, I'm gonna...
Helga reforming the Dawn God.
Before it forces me to join, though. Since nobody has offered me whatever place they want me to go or join, I'm going to join the Stormcloaks, which is my normal side. So, yeah. Apparently I've got to join a side to continue the quest. You sound very panicked, but you look very calm. Okay, dragon, would you mind stop flying around?
Sure.
Yes. Shout, sniper. Okay, this is gonna be a little bit annoying to go and get the body afterwards. Dragon, where are you going? Is the dragon running from me? Missing. Okay, here we go. Can't shout while swimming. He landed anyways. Now I've killed 3 dragons other than the original one. Okay, so now I can go and join Ulfric's side, because apparently I'm forced to choose a side at this point. Empire or the Stormcloaks? I never noticed how big and imposing these gates are.
You come here where you're not wanted. You eat our food, you pollute our city with your stink, and you refuse to help the Stormcloaks.
But we haven't taken a side because it's not our fight.
Hey, maybe the reason these Greyskins don't help in the war is because they're Imperial spies.
Imperial spies? You can't be serious.
Maybe we'll pay you a visit tonight, little spy. We got ways of finding out what you really are.
Oh. Do you hate the Dark Elves? Are you here to bully us and tell us to leave?
No, I don't hate your people.
You've come to the wrong city, then. Windhelm's a haven of prejudice and narrow thinking, unworthy of one such as you. Some of these Nords will come up with any excuse to despise us. And it isn't just the Dark Elves they hate. They make a target of the Argonians as well. In fact, just about anyone who isn't a Nord is fair game for their bullying. Nothing new there. Most of the Nords living in Windhelm don't care much for us. But Rolf is the worst by far.
Rolf.
He likes to get drunk and walk around the Greykwater yelling insults at us in the small hours of the morning. Oh, a real charmer, that one.
I'm gonna go talk to Rolf.
All right, then.
Are you feeling sick?
Okay, I forgot to check. Okay, I've got Whitbane. Magic recovery is half as fast.
I lost my twin sister a while back.
Girl, what are you doing?
Going for a poor old woman, m'lady. The divine.
What's the hurry?
Sorry. Sorry, Nils. He's probably up here somewhere.
The townsfolk called me captain because I used to be a sailor.
Susanna the Wicked.
How can Elda hate the Dark Elves when she knows so little? You didn't hear it from me, but if you want a real dream, did you know that candle on the mantle hasn't gone out in over 100 years?
Susanna the Wicked, that's interesting. Because I think she's the one that the murder mystery that goes on in Windhelm is about. I didn't know she was actually ever alive. I thought she was always just a dead body.
If it's a mercenary you're looking for, you found it. There's no strong.
Okay, it looks like Rolf is here right now.
Skyrim.
I'm actually gonna go check the place where you start the murder mystery. And see if the body's there. Because I'm pretty sure Susanna the Wicked's.
There's no glory in war. Just something
the person who
risked their lives.
Okay, I'm losing my way around the city. This city always confuses me. I think, yeah, here's the graveyard. No, the body's not here. That's interesting. I
Maybe
never
I'm
knew that.
Enough. The dead don't really complain much.
I'm sure that's how that works. The dead don't complain much. Of course, a lot of
few septims for my supper is all I ask.
A lot of jobs
Spare
don't
coin,
cause people to complain at you unless you're like customer support or something like that. And imagine customer support probably really sucks.
It's no secret the Aretino boy is doing some
He'll come around.
Don't be so full of that. We've been to some
Only the foolish or the courageous approach a Jarl without some great. Do I
know
the white one?
You do actually.
Is that so? Yes. You were with us at Helgen. Destined for the chopping block, if I'm not mistaken. Railoff's alive. I hope that's true. He's a damn good man, but he hasn't returned yet. So I'll need to wait for his account. For now, speak with Garmar. I'm always looking for able fighters. Not everyone can say they made it out of Helgen. Seems we're all branded villains these days. So long as your criminal past stays in the past, and you fight for me with honor and integrity, we'll welcome you into our ranks.
Okay, I was just caught because I thought I was a Stormcloak.
If he's not with us, he's against us.
I did as many crimes as he did.
He knows that. Speak with Garmon. It's about time they turned their gaze from the heavens back to our bleeding homeland. What do they want? I have the greatest respect for the Greybeards, of course. And the dragon attacks are a growing plague. But the political situation is still delicate. Not all the Jarls are fully committed to supporting me as High King. I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this unless Tullius himself will be there. Alduin, the world eater of song and legend. If that's true, well, it changes the situation, doesn't it?
Your eyes even Tullius were very may be forced there for
to talk
half
sense
second
in the face of such a threat. Yes, I'll give Tullius one more chance to quit Skyrim with his tail between his legs.
How long are you going to wait?
You think I need to send Balgruuf a stronger message?
If by message you mean...
Okay, now I'm gonna go to Solitude now that I've joined the Stormcloak army. At least I think I joined it. I don't actually remember the quest being continued forwards. Was it? Oh, that's interesting. Okay. I really hope this doesn't cause me to fail the quest, but I guess it's alright anyway, so I'll just do the Imperial quest if this happens. Wait, what's this? Oh, it's the loot symbol. Yeah, the shadow marks, I don't have them all memorized, but I've got a few memorized. Shadow marks are interesting. I watched a video on them. Oh yeah, this is a little bit random. I don't personally know these people, and these people don't personally know me. But whenever most of my information about Skyrim comes from two specific channels, Fudgemuppet, mostly, just Fudge and Muppet, one word. That's where most of my information comes from. And Camelworks, who they often, like, I guess they're friends or something, I'm not really sure on the exact relationship. But that's where I get most of my information for Skyrim, and I just realized this is the wrong place. Okay, wait. What? Oh, okay. But yeah, if you want to go check out those two channels, I guess I'll put links down in the description. And they're where I get most of my information on Skyrim.
I used to be an adventurer like you. Then I took an arrow in the knee.
Sure you did. Alright. Alright, soldier guards.
Watch the skies, traveler.
Here we are again. It's probably going to give me the same little chat, but I think if this goes similar to the Stormcloak, this won't actually cause me to join yet.
I'm telling you, Ulfric's
I remember you. You were at Helgen. Speak to Legatric. I see. Then there's nothing further to discuss. If you change your mind, speak with the Legate.
Oh, the Greybeards. Alright.
What do those old hermits want with me? Why? There's nothing to discuss as long as that traitor Ulfric is in arms against his rightful emperor. They are getting to be a problem, but I wasn't sent to Skyrim to fight dragons. My job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that, dragons or no dragons. I'll be the judge of that. Besides, by all reports, the Stormcloaks are suffering just as much as we are from these dragon attacks. Fair enough. We're driving the Stormcloaks back well enough at the moment.
but we're already overstretched. That's what comes of trying to win a war with a bare handful of legions. If the Emperor would just give me the reinforcements I've requested. Most of the Legion is tied down on the border with the Aldmeri Dominion. The Emperor can't afford to risk weakening Cyrodiil's defenses. From the Imperial City, our war here is just a sideshow. An interlude before the main event against the Thalmor resumes. Yes, yes, fine. I'll come to this Greybeard Council. For all the good it will do.
Okay, I like how there's no time, and I guess places assumed higher up guard. But still, they've just suddenly magically know when to appear.
We need to do something about these vamp.
Hey, Hrothgar.
Violence are gathered here, in these halls whose very stones are dedicated to peace. I should not have agreed to
I'm here, I'm over here.
The Greybeards have no business involving ourselves in such matters.
There we go. Okay, you're kind of wandering away a bit. Okay.
Peace? I doubt it. They may put their weapons down for a moment, but only to gather strength for the next bloodletting.
Perhaps, they're but not yet we just need to stop them for a bit.
Far from it. You know the ancient Nord word for war? Season unending. And so it has proved. But regrets are pointless.
Are you a Nord?
Here
I think
we
all
are.
The Greybeards
take
are Nords,
your seat
right?
At the council table. And let us see what wisdom we
and
can
I'm still
find
over here on gear.
Warriors of Skyrim.
Okay. I think I have to go. No, this isn't the right way. Hrothgar and Windhelm are the two places that most confuse
so,
me.
Arngeir, is it? You know why you're here. Are you going to let us in or not?
Okay. Okay, everybody, let's sit down. Are we going to start? That. You're sitting behind me. I can't look behind me. Except for like this.
Now that everyone is here, please take your seats so we can begin.
I'm already sitting down.
I hope that we have all come
no.
here in the spirit
you insult us by bringing her to this negotiation. Your chief Talos Hunter?
That didn't take long.
Hear, hear.
I have every right to be at this negotiation. I need to ensure that nothing is agreed to here that violates the terms of the White Gold Concordat.
She's part of the Imperial delegation. You can't dictate who I bring to this council.
Please, if we have to negotiate the terms of the negotiation, we will never get anywhere.
It's interesting.
Perhaps this would be a good
I'm not
time
sure if you can hear that in the background.
The
I think that's one of my
matter.
Little brother's alarms.
The nerve of those Imperial bastards, eh? To think that I would sit down
oh, he's talking to me.
That
also, it's interesting, Esbern and Delphine are here, but Arngeir and the rest of the Greybeards don't seem to be complaining about them. Actually, that might have been what was happening in the other room whenever I came over here.
Maybe so, but bringing her here is a deliberate provocation. Tullius needs to know I won't be pushed around.
Alright.
Well said.
Very well, Ulfric. Enjoy your petty victory.
The Thalmor will treat with whatever government rules Skyrim. We would not think of interfering in your civil war.
Ah, Skyrim will never bow to the Thalmor.
Can you please just sit
unlike
down?
Your imperial friends here.
You're lucky I respect the Greybeard's council, Galmar.
Legate, we represent the Emperor here.
Sorry, sir. It won't happen again.
Now that that's settled, may we proceed?
Okay, there we go.
I have something to say first.
Here we go.
The only reason I agreed to attend this council was to deal with the dragon menace. There's nothing else to talk about. Unless the Empire is finally ready to renounce its unjust claim to rule over the free people of Skyrim.
I knew he wouldn't.
We're here to arrange a temporary truce to allow the Dragonborn here to deal with the dragons, nothing more. I consider even talking to the Empire a generous gesture.
Are you done? Did you just come here to make speeches, or can we get down to business?
Yes, let's get this over with.
Are we ready to proceed?
Yes.
Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, this council is unprecedented. We are gathered here at the Dragonborn's request. I ask that you all respect the spirit of High Hrothgar. Do your best to begin the process of achieving a lasting peace in Skyrim. Who would like to open the negotiations?
Yes, let's get down to it. We want control of Markarth. That's our price for agreeing to a truce.
So that's why you're here, Ulfric? You dare to insult the Greybeards by using this council to advance your own position?
Jarl Elisif.
General, this is outrageous. You can't be taking this demand seriously. I thought we were here to discuss a truce.
Elisif, I said I'd handle it.
Can't the price be
Ulfric,
you both?
You can't seriously expect us to give up Markarth at the negotiating table. You hope to gain in council what you've been unable to take in battle, is that it?
I'm He's sure actually Jarl quite a while Ulfric away from taking
does not expect something for nothing.
Markarth.
Yes, that'd be entirely
what would the Empire
character.
Want in return?
Wait, General, you don't intend to just hand over Markarth to that traitor?
This is how the Empire repays us for our loyalty? Enough. First, let's be clear. This council wasn't my idea. I think it's a waste of time. You are a traitor to the Empire and deserve a traitor's death. But I at least will negotiate in good faith. Since we're all here at your request, I'd like to hear what you think Markarth is worth.
I think I'm gonna try to be fair here instead of leaning towards the Imperial. Dawnstar doesn't really do much. Riften is a more worthwhile thing, I think. So I'm gonna say Riften.
The Rift would help secure our communications with Cyrodiil and threaten Ulfric's southern flank.
The Dragonborn has spoken, Tullius. Markarth will be ours. Now we'll see if there's anything behind your talk of good faith.
You disappoint me, Dragonborn. I accepted your invitation on trust in
what?
Your good name. But it seems you intend to favor Ulfric.
I was trying to be fair. Would you rather have Dawnstar?
I know you, Ulfric. If I hand over Markarth, you'll be ready with a new demand. You'll never defeat the Empire, and you know it. But you're willing to sacrifice thousands for your own selfish ambition.
I was trying to be fair.
You back under the
Riften's worth more than Dawnstar, in my opinion.
As always, the Empire's fine words are worth nothing.
Stop! Are you so blind to our danger that you can't see past your petty disagreements? Here you sit arguing about nothing, while the fate of the land hangs in the balance.
Is he with you, Delphine? If so, I advise you to tell him to watch his tongue.
He is with me. And I advise you both to listen to what he has to say before you do anything rash.
Don't you understand the danger? Don't you understand what the return of the dragons means? Alduin has returned the World Eater. Even now, he devours the souls of your fallen comrades. He grows more powerful with every soldier slain in your pointless war. Can you not put aside your hatred for even one moment in the face of this mortal danger?
I don't know about the end of the world, but this dragon situation has gotten out of hand. If this truce will help the Dragonborn here put an end to that menace, we both gain. Remember that, Alfred.
Yeah, why can't your...
Back to the matter at hand.
Price for the... I think I said that earlier, but why can't your price for the truce be the other person's truce?
Where will these demands end?
I'm listening.
We want compensation for the massacre at Karthwaistan.
You slaughtered the very people you claim to be fighting for. True sons of Skyrim would never do such things.
Damned Imperial lies. My men would never stoop to such methods, even in retaliation.
This is our homeland, Tullius. All the blood spilled in this war is on your head.
So, Dragonborn, what do you say?
I feel like he felt a little bit unfair about the Riften thing, so...
Well said. For once you'll actually pay for your crimes. I suppose that's the fairest deal we're likely to get.
It seems we may have an agreement. Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, these are the terms currently on the table. Markarth will be handed over to Ulfric's forces, Jarl Igmund will step down, and Thangvor Silverblood will become the Jarl of Markarth. The Stormcloaks will withdraw from the Rift, allowing Imperial troops unhindered access. Jarl Leila Lawgiver will step down.
Maven Blackbriar becomes Riften?
The Jarl of Riften.
Becomes the Jarl? Wow.
The Stormcloaks will pay appropriate compensation for the massacre at Karthwaistan. You both agree to this?
The sons of Skyrim will live up to their agreements, as long as the Imperials hold to them. What about you, Elisif? Are these terms to your liking? Speak up! I'm sure General Tullius is waiting to do your bidding.
I have nothing to say to that murderer. General, you've proven yourself a good friend to Skyrim. I continue to trust that you will do your utmost to safeguard our interests.
Thank you, Jarl Elisif. I appreciate your loyalty. The Empire can live with these terms, yes, for a temporary truce, until the dragon menace is dealt with. After that, Ulfric, there will be a reckoning. Count on it.
Okay, the Imperials got more out of this than anybody else.
Giving up Markarth is a heavy price for this truce, Dragonborn.
Okay, here, wait. I'm gonna...
I hope it was worth it.
Okay, we've been recording for a bit over an hour now. I think I'm probably gonna have to stop now. Not much happened in this episode. Let's see,
yes,
we finished with the thing for the Elder Scroll, and we fought Alduin for the first time.
But the difficulty remains.
Other than that, we just did some shopping and negotiation while we're at it. So for now, I think we're probably gonna have basically a stop here after this little conversation. That's nice.
Cross-reference this in the Delphine's map of Dragon Barriers. I believe I've identified one of the Dragon Barriers. Don't you see? The names of dragons are always three words of power. Shouts.
Yeah, I've seen.
By calling the dragon,
I've noticed.
He will hear you wherever you might be. He's not compelled to, but dragons are prideful and loathe. Your voice in particular is like it could treat this guy. After a victory of war, I think it's very likely that he will be unable to resist investigating your call. I'm no master of voice like these, worthy gentlemen, but it is written here in the scroll. Oda Thee,
winged snow hunter with a ring.
There's one more thing. We know of it. Parthenax, the dragon that the Greybeards have been protecting for all these years. He needs to
I'm
die.
Not gonna kill
he
him.
He deserves to die.
At least not for a while. I might eventually, but for
and
now
so
I'm not gonna
dead.
Kill him.
Well, I'm sorry, but we would dishonor our oaths as blades if we continue to help you.
Okay, well, I think that's it for now. If you'd enjoyed, please leave a like. If you want to see more, then subscribe. Goodbye.